A one-night stay and two all-day passes to their indoor theme park.
Every Friday, we draw another name. You have till noon the following Monday to email us. Call us to claim your fabulous prize. Who's got one today?
He was pretty scary as Cato in 2012's The Hunger Games. Alexander Ludwig turns 23 years old today.
Today's National Roast Leg of Lamb Day.
Just odd sometimes what the days are.
It's good stuff, though. On this date, in 1998, Mercedes-Benz bought Chrysler for $40 billion and formed Daimler-Chrysler, largest industrial merger in history.
I remember that. That was big doings.
Big time, baby.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Here's one for you. On this date in 2012, paleoclimatological research claims dinosaur flatulence may have warmed the earth. And apparently, cavemen back in the time, at least the conservative ones, you know, the cavemen would go, oh, it's getting so warm, there's global warming taking place, and the conservative cavemen would say, global warming, that's just dinosaur flatulence.
That was their joke, or?
No, I think that's Charlie's commentary.
Yeah.
That's what they said. But, you know, nothing's recorded, because, you know, it's cavemen times. All right, the bring it down moment. 1915 on this date, the German submarine U-20 sank the RMS Lusitania, killing 1,198 people, including 128 Americans. Public reaction to the sinking turned many pro-Germans against Germany, and that's what led us into World War I. 1915 on this date. Now for your viewing pleasure. I take you to this isn't 1945, but this would be, and I apologize, my French is not so good. I believe this is Reims, France, or Reims, France.
Reims?
Yeah, I don't know. But anyway, this is where the unconditional surrender of the Germans took place in World War II, at least the original one. On May 7th, 1945, it was the headquarters of the Supreme Allied Expeditionary Force. But, and this is what it looked like when they were signing the documents, the Soviets protested that that surrender. They felt, first of all, that it shouldn't be taking place on France soil. It should take place in Germany, where the Germans were surrendering unconditionally to the war. So a second document was signed in Germany the next day, and that's what they consider VE Day, Victory in Europe Day.
I did not know
that. The first
that.
Document was signed on this date in...
I wonder if it's Reims or Reims.
Reims or Reims. It was an old, brick schoolhouse, still there. They turned it into a museum, and you saw that the flags of each of the countries were flying outside. So you can actually go into the room, and, you know, you're kind of roped off, but the actual table's still there and all the maps and everything where the document was signed.